Welcome. My name is Zhibin Guo. I'm the application engineer at Bettersize. In this talk, I'm going to introduce the next generation of particle sizing, Bettersizer S3 Plus. This is a comprehensive particle size and shape analyzer. What can the Bettersizer S3 Plus offer you? It has very unique features and benefits. The first one is innovative and patented DLO iOS. Even nanoparticles starting at just 10 nanometers can be reliably analyzed. Then, combination technology. The Bettersizer S3 Plus has not only laser diffraction system, but also the image analysis system, offering a measuring range up to 3,500 microns. Then, dual camera system. Important shape parameters can be measured. The agglomerates and oversized particles can be visualized. Last, refractive index measurement. A tool to determine the complex refractive index of the sample was incorporated in the S3 Plus, which can greatly increase the accuracy and reliability of the particle size measurements, especially in the scientific field. Okay, let me start with a brief introduction with the particle sizing. Have a look at the different measurement methods of particle sizing. The measurement range is from 0.1 nanometers to 1,000 microns. For example, the well-known sieve analysis is suitable for measuring micron-sized particles, and dynamic light scattering is for measuring nano and submicron particles. For laser diffraction, it is appropriate to measure micron-sized particles with a wide range covering from tens of nanometers to several microns. Since the 1970s, laser diffraction has become one of the most important and widely accepted methods for the determination of particle size distribution. What is laser diffraction? Laser light is coherent and almost monochromatic. In other words, it consists of light of one wavelength. If it hits a particle, then depending on the size of this particle, different physical effects occur, including refraction when passing through a surface boundary, diffraction at a particle with a diameter significantly greater than the wavelength of the light and without interaction with the material itself. Then, light scattering at a particle in the size range of the wavelength or below, in which an interaction with electrons takes place. Laser diffraction as a particle size measurement method is therefore based on the deflection of light at particles that are much larger than the light's wavelength. If we visualize the laser diffraction as such an object in forward direction on a screen, a diffraction pattern with several intensity maxima and minima is created. A larger particle diffracts the laser beam less than a smaller particle. In other words, a larger particle diffracts at a smaller angle. Therefore, the light spectra of the small particles must be recorded by detectors at larger angles. These are the diffraction images at different particles in two-dimensional and three-dimensional view. On the right, the laser diffraction on multiple particles is shown. Then, photoelectrical detectors can be installed at the focal plane, which translates the light signals to electrical signals and input into a specialized software. Based on near scattering theory and inverse algorithm, particle size distribution can be finally obtained. However, laser diffraction does not provide information on particle shape or whether the calculated distribution corresponds to reality. So, dynamic image analysis, another measurement method, can be used as a complementary system for particle size analysis. By counting the number of particles and the number of pixels contained in each particle projection, the equivalent circle area for each particle can be calculated. A complete dynamic image measurement includes sample preparation, measurement, image analysis, and report. It has the characteristics of intuitive, visual, accurate, wide measurement range, etc. With dynamic image analysis, the particle parameters, including the equivalent area diameter, ferrite max and mean, circularity, and aspect ratio, can be provided. So it is a new particle sizing tool for research and production of powder materials. The Bettersizer S3 Plus incorporates the laser diffraction and dynamic image analysis. In other words, two measurement systems are installed on one unit. You can use laser diffraction only, or dynamic image analysis only, or use these two methods simultaneously to characterize your sample, depending on your applications. Now I'm going to show you the features of the Bettersizer S3 Plus in a comprehensive way. I will cover the optical system DLOIOS first, which is one of the most unique features of this instrument. This is the general setup of the optical bench of the Bettersizer S3 Plus. As we see, it combines the laser system and the image system. I will introduce the laser system first. On the base platform on the right side of the sample cell, a laser diode that is green with the wavelength of 532 nanometers, backscatter detectors and a Fourier lens are located directly in front of the sample cell. Another Fourier lens and the forward detectors are located to the left of the sample cell. The laser is placed in an oblique position towards the sample cell, ensuring the widest possible scattering angle range of the lateral or front detectors. What role do these lenses play in this instrument? First of all, we must understand the two optical setups, classical Fourier design and inverse Fourier design. For Fourier design, with focal length at the detector level, convex lens is placed behind particles. Fourier design measures particles only in working distance of the lens, and the focal length determines the measurement range. The disadvantage of Fourier design is that very small particles are not detectable because of focusing is not available for high diffraction angles. For inverse Fourier setup, convex lens is placed in front of particles, and convergent is all particles. The disadvantage of inverse Fourier design is the limited angle range. In addition, particles must form monolayer or at the same focus. After introducing the respective shortcomings of two setups, let's take a look at how DLOIOS built a new optical platform to avoid the shortcomings of both. Lens 1 focuses the scatter light in the forward direction into the detector plane, according to the classical Fourier design. Lenses 2 generates a parallel laser beam, which hits the particles, and on the other hand, it acts as a collecting lens and focuses the scatter light backwards toward backscattering detectors. Therefore, the DLOIOS design is based on the classical Fourier design, since both lenses act as converging lenses, focus the scatter light onto the detectors. The challenge of precisely measuring small particles using the Fourier setup is overcome by adding the second Fourier lens, and thus allowing the backscatter light to be detected. In addition, the particles in the sample cell do not have to be in one plane, which is a major disadvantage of the common inverse Fourier design. In combination with the laser arranged obliquely to the sample cell, this leads to a detection of the scatter light over a very large angle range, from 0.02 to 165 degrees, with excellent detector resolution. The diagonal instance of light caused the scattering angle range at the lateral and front detectors to widen. The very wide angle coverage also has the advantage. There's no need for a second and shorter wavelength laser, and therefore no scattering spectra of mixed wavelengths are measured, which actually cannot be evaluated with the mere model due to the wavelength dependence of the refractive index. Therefore, the Bettersizer S3 Plus can measure the full size range of particles down to submicrons without any compromise. DLOIOS technology allows it to have the very accurate result for the standard sample. In summary, due to the patented DLOIOS technology, in combination with a high-resolution detector system, the Bettersizer S3 Plus compensates for a great disadvantage of the conventional Fourier setup and even increases the precision for small particles in comparison to the inverse Fourier setup, therefore allowing precise measurements and a stable, uniform optical system. Next, I'm going to introduce the combination technology that the Bettersizer S3 Plus is very proud of. Let's have a closer look at the optical bench structure of the Bettersizer S3 Plus. In addition to the classical components for performing the light scattering experiment, lasers, lenses, detectors, a camera system is implemented. These are two high-speed CCD cameras up to 70 frames per second, which enable sharp detection of moving particles at different magnifications, and therefore an additional evaluation with dynamic image analysis. The high-speed CCD cameras, 0.5-fold and 10-fold, record images of coarse particles and statistically evaluate the results. This figure shows the measurement setup. During the measurement, the particles to be measured move through the sample cell and cause the recorded light scattering spectrum. After that, they pass the camera cell. So, the data collection, laser diffraction, and image analysis, they are done at the same time. During the measurement, the live CCD camera picture can be switched on online, helping the user to directly evaluate dispersion and particle shape, such as spheres, agglomerates, and possibly air bubbles. As already mentioned, the image system of the Bettersizer S3 Plus can be used in two ways, image analysis only or combined test. I will cover the combined test first. Combination technology is utilized in order to provide the highest measuring precision for very coarse particles, especially in the case of very wide particle size distribution. Small fractions in the particle coarse range are hardly to be found, but often play an important role in practice. In detail, two phenomena make the reliable measurement of the coarse fraction more difficult. On the one hand, coarse particles scatter the light exclusively in the forward direction, which makes it difficult to differentiate between or classify them with only minor differences in size. On the other hand, in widely distributed particle systems, the coarse particles are statistically underrepresented, which in turn makes their detection more difficult in the presence of a large number of small particles. Therefore, it is particularly useful to combine laser diffraction with dynamic image analysis to benefit from the advantage of both methods. However, this combination of two methods is a challenge because it requires a powerful optical bench, an ultra-fast and high-resolution camera system, as well as compelling software to process all the information directly online. The Bettersizer S3 Plus uses one of the CCD cameras, 0.5-fold, to photograph and statistically evaluate the coarse particles. The results from laser diffraction and dynamic image analysis are combined in an intelligent routine by weighting based on the concentration determination of both methods. The combined measurement results obtained in this way can then be separated from each other, and the influence of the combination technology compared to the pure laser diffraction or pure image analysis can be worked out. I'm going to give an example to explain it in detail later. This example shows a study on measuring corundum by using laser diffraction with simultaneous dynamic image analysis. Three corundum powders, fine, medium, and coarse, were measured by the Bettersizer S3 Plus to characterize both the particle size and shape. Here we demonstrate how these powders differ in size, as well as how they compare in their shape parameters. As shown in the figure, after the characterization of three different samples, particle size results rank in the correct order, as we would expect. Interestingly, despite of the different sizes of three powders, their circularity is significantly uniform, which means the grinding process of the manufacturer for these powders is very well under control. Then a new sample was mixed from fine, medium, and coarse samples for demo purposes. The particle size distribution of four samples, including the mix, are shown in this figure. The analysis of that mixture indicates the presence of the three original materials, as to be expected, and consequently, the high-resolution capability of the combination technology is therefore verified. In addition, with dynamic image analysis technique based on counting, the Bettersizer S3 Plus is capable of easily identifying overly large or too spherical particles, or creating number-based distribution and other parameters by viewing all the size and shape data parameters of all the particles. This figure shows several images of the coarse corundum in detail. The number shown above the image is the particular diameter for each particle. One of the primary shape parameters generated by the Bettersizer S3 Plus is circularity. The more spherical the particle, the closer its circularity approaches 1. The more elongated the particle, the lower its circularity. The selected shape parameters were able to offer information about the particle morphology. As already mentioned, in the case of particles with a broad size distribution, coarse particles are hardly found as the majority of small particles dominate the statistics, but image system can solve this problem well. With the combination technology, the Bettersizer S3 Plus enables us to see any large particles that may have been out of specification. This is one of the examples. An off-specification corundum powder provided by the manufacturer is investigated, and the results are shown in the figure. Firstly, this sample was measured by a laser analyzer of another manufacturer other than Bettersize. The results confirm the presence of small particles of around 1 micron, thereby illustrating the overgrinding of powders. Next, the Bettersizer S3 Plus was utilized. With the laser diffraction method alone, the main peak at around 40 microns and a small peak at 1 micron were indicated in the figure. Finally, the corundum powder was studied by the combination technology of the Bettersizer S3 Plus. Interestingly, there's another small peak located beside the main peaks at around 120 microns. The overall results indicate the presence of unwanted ultrafine particles as well as large particles in this powder. In order to confirm the presence of oversized particles that were underground, images of large particles are therefore acquired and shown in this table, proving unwanted large particles exist in this off-specification sample. This experiment proves that Bettersizer S3 Plus combining laser diffraction with image system allows higher accuracy in the coarse range than conventional laser analyzers and enables rapid identification of off-specification product. Besides the combined use of dynamic image analysis and laser diffraction, the Bettersizer S3 Plus camera system also offers the ability to perform dynamic image analysis only. For particle shape analysis, the Bettersizer S3 Plus optionally offers two high-speed CCD cameras with a recording speed of about 10,000 particles per minute. Both cameras can be used individually for image analysis or in combination in the case of very widely distributed samples. Each single particle is captured, stored as an image, numbered, and statistically evaluated. The intuitive and powerful software allows to obtain essential information about the particle shape from the captured images. Different equivalent diameters, as well as aspect ratio, circularity, and perimeter are calculated. Dynamic image analysis can clearly see and measure the parameters of each particle, and also calculate its morphological values. For large particles, not only the size and morphology, but also the absolute number of particles can be given. Especially for anisotropic particles such as flakes, this is an advantage over classical laser diffraction, which is based on the evaluation of spherical particles. The determination of equivalent diameters furthermore provides users with a valuable comparison with other particle size analyzers, such as Zhibin, to verify the test results. This is an example on characterizations of sieve glass beads using the dynamic image analysis. Commercially available glass beads, which were sieved between 400 microns and 800 microns, were measured by the Bettersizer S3 Plus, and the particle size distribution was determined. For coarse particles, the result is slightly greater than the maximum size of 800 microns expected with the sieving method. Why is that? As we see in the images, even if circularity larger than 0.9 is broadly defined, the majority of glass spheres seems to greatly differ from the ideal spherical shape. It's obvious that in the circularity scatter plot, the majority of glass beads deviates from the ideal sphere. Based on the circularity histogram, more than 35% of the particles are not completely circular, and therefore resulting in the size differences determined with the sieving and dynamic image analysis. Last, I'm going to introduce a very special feature of the Bettersizer S3 Plus, refractive index measurement. What is refractive index? It's a value calculated from the ratio of the speed of light in a vacuum to that in a second medium of greater density. As presented in the figure, if the incident light is oblique to the surface, an incident light upon a plane surface separating two media is refracted when entering the second medium. So the refractive index is essentially a material constant. However, for the mathematical fit for particle size analysis, according to Mir theory, the optical properties of the sample must be considered, which largely depend on chemical purity or composition, such as impurities and mixtures, and crystal structure and optical dispersion, which means the influence of the wavelength on the refractive index, and particle shape, which can cause reflection and scattering at irregularly shaped interfaces. Therefore, the evaluation of scale light spectra is extremely demanding when measuring newly synthesized materials, samples with impurities, or sample with small f number. In order to solve these problems, a tool to determine the complex refractive index was developed by Bettersize. For particle size measurements and their evaluation according to Mir theory, the refractive indices of more than 200 pure substances are available in the database of the Bettersizer software, and this can be extended by any number of materials. The software then provides the five complex refractive indices with the highest agreement to the scientific theory, whereby the only one with the highest credibility is the recommended one for the analyzed sample. The table lists the complex refractive indices determined by the Bettersizer software compared to the literature values. It can be seen the values partly correspond, while in other cases, there are clear differences between pure material and real sample due to the above-mentioned phenomena. In addition to all the features mentioned above, the powerful analyzer, Bettersizer S3 Plus, has acquired International Quality Management Certification and the European CE Certification. In summary, four features are innovatively implemented in the Bettersizer S3 Plus. The challenges and limits of the both Fourier and inverse Fourier technology are overcome in the Bettersizer S3 Plus by the innovative dual lenses and oblique instance optical system. In addition to visualizing and evaluating particles, the image analysis system in the Bettersizer S3 Plus allows a high measuring precision for very coarse particles using the 0.5-fold CCD camera, which is particularly useful for the detection of oversized particles. And detailed particle shape determination with oversized particle analysis and agglomerate check, optionally with 0.5-fold and 10-fold or with both CCD cameras combined. The intelligent determination of the refractive index of unknown samples in the Bettersizer S3 Plus includes a measurement and calculation procedure for the complex refractive index and offers new possibilities, especially for research. Okay, this is the end of this presentation. I hope you find this video helpful. Please be sure to leave any comments or questions below, and check out the Bettersize website for more detailed information on each instrument. Thanks for watching.